So 4 years ago is when I first got into landscape photography, and you know, I was all excited at the time. I was wanting to get the best gear and gadgets and tech associated with photography, and I was all fired up about that. And I kept hearing the same theme about, you know, if you're going to be into landscape photography, if you're going to focus on that, you got to get an L bracket or an L plate. I wasn't really 100% sure exactly what it was, so hopped on YouTube and looked at a couple of videos, and it doesn't take very long to figure out exactly what it is. And from my point of view at the time, it was just a way to save time, you know, going from landscape to portrait orientation. I would no longer have to, you know, roll my ball head over like this. It would enable me to save a lot of time and not have to do that. I could just unclip my camera from the ball head and flip it over. And I thought about that, and I was like, yeah, that sounds nice and everything, but I don't know if that's really worth the $50 or $150 that I surely didn't have at the time. And so I just kind of dismissed it and moved on, and I shot for the first part of the year without one and didn't really think much about it. And the reason I'm telling this story is about a month ago, or maybe 3 weeks ago, I got a message on Twitter, and not hundreds of them, just one single message from a woman who was just getting into landscape photography, and she was asking my opinion on whether or not I thought L brackets were really even worth it, or if they were actually needed. And that question really just kind of, sparked my memory going back to a few years ago when I first got into photography. And, the funny thing about an L bracket is you don't really know what you got until it's gone. And that's why, I think that an L bracket has got to be the most underappreciated kit in a landscape photographer's bag or piece of kit. And, it's like I said, it's one of those things. Once you start shooting with an L bracket, you really become used to it. And, you bolt it on your camera, you don't really take it off ever. So it just kind of just becomes one of those things you just don't think much about. So you definitely kind of, underappreciate the value that it provides. And, some of the things that it actually does for you, of course, it will wrap your camera in steel. About 50% of it is definitely going to cover the bottom of your camera and one of the sides, just depending on the manufacturer you go with and, of course, what material they use. So the added protection is always a big benefit. And then, of course, if you shoot a lot of panos, normally you want to do that in portrait orientation. And if you don't have an L bracket, you're going to have to go with the resort of rolling your ball head over, and you're just going to have to spin your camera around like this to get your pano, which is not good at all because the center of your lens is actually changing as you move around the actual ball head. So when you go to stitch that together in Photoshop or Lightroom, it's not going to stitch together very cleanly. It's not going to create a very pleasing result. But if you do have an L bracket, you can simply just put it in portrait mode, and then you can just spin the ball head around. This way, the center of your lens actually never moves the plane. It's all centered right around here, and it's going to basically just make an image or make a series of images that stitch perfectly together in post, which of course has got to be one of the most important parts of shooting a panoramic, is that all the images stitch together appropriately. It just becomes a giant puzzle. So, but that's not even the most important benefit to me personally. And what that is not needing to recompose. And what I mean by that is, landscape photography, it feels like you're always running out of time. The sun's setting or rising, or the storm's rolling through or something. You always feel like you're in a rush. And if you don't have an L bracket and you want to switch to a portrait orientation at the last minute, you're going to have to roll that ball head over. But what's happening is the center of your lens is here. If you roll your ball head over, the center of your lens is now down here, and your entire composition has shifted to the right or toward the left, and that's completely changed your entire composition. You're now going to have to go back and change the height of your tripod, because you don't want to point your camera up to compensate for the fact that you just lowered your entire camera, because that's not going to be good. You're going to have to adjust all the legs of your tripod, and then you're going to have to readjust and recompose and kind of really get in there to compensate from the way you moved your camera. It's a lot of extra time. And I don't know about you guys, but it takes me forever to come up with a good composition. And when I do, I don't want anything touching it. at all. So the big benefit is if you have an L bracket and you want to shoot in a portrait mode, which I shoot almost all my images in a portrait mode, you can simply just detach your camera from the ball head, flip it over, and you're good to go. The composition has remained exactly the same. The height has remained exactly the same. You can just go to shooting. It's amazing what that will do for you. And like I said, once you start using it, it's very difficult to ever stop using an L bracket. Once you really get into it, it really becomes part of your workflow. So the first L bracket I got was some kind of cheap generic brand. It wasn't even made for my particular camera at that time. And it didn't even fit that well, but it gave me enough of an idea to realize that, you know what, this is something I don't mind investing some money into to get a really good one. I actually have the Really Right Stuff L bracket now that is made for the Sony a7R Mark II, and I'll take it over here on the desk so you can take a closer look at it, and I'll take it off and show you how it comes off and comes back on, and that way you can get a closer look at it. All right, so this is the L bracket that I use. It's the Really Right Stuff L plate. It's a BA7R2-L set. It retails for $175, which is probably the most expensive L bracket you will see on the market today, but it is definitely worth every penny. As you can see, it's fit just for this the Sony a7R Mark II. It fits it like an absolute glove. And all of the L brackets that Really Right Stuff makes are custom made for a specific camera, just so it fits perfectly. Now, what's really cool is that it's required to have this hex key to take the L bracket off, and it's got a little mechanism, like a little magnet in there that just kind of sucks it in there, and it's always part of the L bracket. It's always there. That way you don't ever lose it. You don't ever have to go scurrying around trying to find it if you want to take the bracket off. So it's very simple to do. You simply just unscrew this top piece here, and the actual L bracket itself is two pieces. So you take that off. There's another small little eyelet screw right here that holds this little area in. It's kind of like a secondary measure. I'm not sure exactly how much additional support it provides, but it says to use it. So I'm not one to buck a trend, so I used it. All right, flip it back over. And that piece comes off there. And then there's one more screw right here. And that's really it. Takes less than 60 seconds to take it off and on. And easy as can be, really. I don't think I've taken this off since I put it on, actually. Now you'll notice something interesting here, that the battery door is missing from my camera, and that's because the battery door is actually on the L bracket itself now. And it's kind of interesting that that Sony made this battery door with the purpose to actually come off, and I'm not sure the reason why they designed it to come off, but for whatever reason they did. There's a little lever right in there that you just flip it and the door comes off. And it mounts directly to this Really Right Stuff L plate, which is it makes for a very nice integration of the component itself. And you can see the actual grooves where your ball head or your clamp will clamp down. This is this is the landscape orientation side. And in this area right here, it would be for the portrait. So it's got nice deep grooves. So it's very confident locking when you lock your clamp down on your ball head. You can feel confident that it's not gonna fall off. So, and putting it back on is as easy as it was to take off. Just three total screws. Let's put this one back in here. Like that. And then we'll put this second piece on here. And so as you can see, there's not a whole lot to it. It's just nice that it's machined metal just for the Sony a7R II. So when you put it on, there's no wiggling. It's not moving around at all. It feels like it has become part of the camera itself, which is a very good feeling. You want it to feel like that. You don't want any kind of wiggling or anything like that. So it's a fantastic thing. And like I mentioned earlier, it's gotta be the most underappreciated piece of kit in a landscape photographer's bag. It is absolutely critical in my opinion. So good stuff. Yeah, so if you're just getting into landscape photography now, or if you've been shooting it for years and just not sure if you want to jump into purchasing an L bracket just yet, I hope the video was informative and possibly gave you some additional detail to help you make your decision. If you have any questions, just shoot me a comment below. I guarantee I'll get back to you. And I'll also put links in the description below to the L bracket that I use as well. So if you want to take a closer look at that and get a little bit more details from that, you can. And thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in next week's video. Bye.